out in the pits here at the National Hot Rod Association. Attention in the pits, historic episode. We're going to double up with a racer for the first time. Everybody remembers Keith Mayers, one of the more popular Attention in the Pits ever, and his Porsche, one of two Porsches that race. But unfortunately, something happened to the Porsche. We'll learn about that. But he's debuting a brand new race car. Keith Mayers back on Attention in the Pits. First time we've doubled up with anybody, and for good reason. What are we looking at here?
This is an Alfa Romeo Spider, and I'm going to screw this up for sure, but it's a Quadrifoglio, which kind of means four-leaf clover in Italian. It was a special edition car that I really wasn't aware of at the time, so the purists really got mad when I posted the car on there. They, you know, why would you do that to a quad? Oh, it's my car.
Well, exactly, and I'm sure there was some sort of issue with the car that you got it. Like, you didn't cut up a matching numbers, low miles Alfa Romeo, or did you?
Oh, no, no. This was a mechanic special over in Annapolis. A tow truck driver had it for probably over a year or something, and the guy just signed a title over and just didn't want to fix it. So when I got it, I don't know what worked and what didn't, but I had the entire car, and I sold a lot of the parts off to get started with some of the parts and all.
All right, but people are out there. I know they're wondering, and don't worry, folks. We're going to go over every aspect of this car because it's amazing, unfolding the layers. But what happened to the Porsche?
I had a unfortunate accident at Maple Grove last year, past the 8th mile, and I put the nose into the guardrail a few times. It's all fixed now. I did. I got lucky enough to find a new front end out in Ohio, which was a 968, which is a little different. I had to modify it a little bit, but now it's a totally different looking car. So I know I've got the only 968 that runs.
Well, exactly. All right, we're gonna delve into that, but tell us about this ride. Okay, so this was a regular car and you cut it up. Just lead us through, because there is a lot of attention to detail going on here, like the chassis. What did you do that? You built that yourself, correct?
Yes, sir, I did. Now, I had some friends obviously involved in it. Scott Sapp, we went over a couple years of thinking about what we were going to do, and I was looking for a Fiat or something small. I actually had a Fiat Spider when I was a kid.
Where does this come from? Like, okay, he has a Porsche, now he's got an Alfa. You don't like Camaros?
No, I grew up down near Ocean City, Maryland, and I was a surfer, and convertibles are great to throw the boards in and pick up the chicks. You know, those days are long gone, but I still like the cars anyway. Bring
awesome.
Back good memories.
All right, so this is a kit chassis, but you had to modify it to be an Alfa. What was it?
Yes, the chassis was a, I don't want to say the manufacturer, but it was a 27T Roadster chassis kit, and the only one I could really find in mild steel, because, you know, I have to build it up to weight to fit the class. So it's a mild steel, and we stretched it, widened it to fit the body quite a bit, over a foot, added a whole lot of bars, extra bars to it and stuff, and, you know, made the wheelbase kind of fit the car, or the car fit the wheelbase. Yeah,
exactly. All right, so we'll get you in the cockpit later, but I know you wanted to open up the trunk and kind of showcase your work. But just so everybody understands, this is nose to tail Keith Mayers and his friends building this car, including the paint, correct?
Oh, yes, sir. I had a body shop for years, a small little body shop I did work in, and this is actually, you know, pretty inexpensive paint and stuff I had laying around for the stripes and whatnot. The body work is crazy because there was a lot of it. The car's probably got 200 pounds of filler in it, but it's all steel. And I'll run through you with it what I had to add metal to stretch the chassis, and obviously the rear's been moved back and the quarter panels. But it is an all steel car, and there's lots of neat little quirks about it.
Okay, let's see under the rear trunk. Start taking stuff apart, Keith. Keith Mayers, super street car. The Porsche is still alive. Do not fear. You can see all kinds of like ghost effects in the stripes, which is really cool. It's obviously heavy metal flake going on. Alfa Romeo Spider. And yes, here's the clover leaf back here. I don't know if everybody got to see the clover leaf, but that he was referencing right there, making it a special edition. And when people see this, they become aggravated.
Show you this. Because of the wheel tubs, these are actually VP drums, leftover drums, and I put them on the cracking the cement floor and stretched them out by stomping on them a little bit and made wheel tubs out of drums. So don't throw your drums away. There's always another purpose for them.
Okay, I know. Hold on. I'm wrapping my mind around that. This is a VP 55-gallon drum?
It sure is. That's what they are, yeah.
I love the bead roll right here. Like, you're great with a giant bead roller.
Yeah, it looks like a stock, you know, that you bought it, but it was just something laying around. And I have a tendency to do stuff with what I've got laying around.
Yeah, we can tell by your tow vehicle, which we have seen in the past as well. All right, explain what we're looking at. I know that there is a lot of personal work that you put into this in addition to the VP drums.
Okay, yeah, I did buy it. I want to be able to run this car in brackets and other classes, so I put in a Jones Racing pump, and it can circulate the transmission fluid and all, and it's tucked away back here. My battery, obviously, and all my electronics back here that go to it. I put in circuit breakers and stuff back here. I like to do my own wiring and stuff. And basically, you know, stuff like I didn't have a battery switch inside before, and I don't want to be inside the car and get stuck with that, so I included that. And that's just most of the stuff back here. All the lights work, and you know, we even ended up putting a tag on the car. That's a high-dollar Delaware tag.
I love it. All right, let's see under the hood, if you don't mind. You can leave this open for now, but yeah. Keith Mayers, the VP drums, kind of a shocker. But that is the ingenuity of the NHRA drag racer, taking things that appear useless and making them into a race car that runs in Super Street.
Now, this is where you're going to see... This is where you're going to see the stretch on this car. I cut it here and added the 7 inches of steel in the fender, which you won't be able to tell off the get-go, but I wanted to keep the body line here, so you'll definitely notice it when I open it.
All right.
This is the stock factory hood, as you can see here, and here's my 7 inches to make up the difference in the hood. And I kept the factory hood. I just added this little spring so it wouldn't get blown around when it's open. It's real convenient to have the hood open like this. I can get to my fuel, and these are removable so you can get to your rocker arms and stuff. But I think it turned out pretty good.
Amazing. And is this a separate engine, or is this the engine out of the Porsche? Or?
This is the one out of the Porsche because, like I say, the track prep, I don't really think it's getting much better, and it was getting out of control. That car only had a 97-inch wheelbase, to where this one is now, it's actually a four-link and a 101 wheelbase, so it's a lot more stable with this motor in it.
Everything you learned with that car, you applied it to this car to make it even better.
Oh, absolutely. Every little trick that I have in the other car, including the stereo and, you know, just where the layout of things, everything was thought out really good.
Get in the car, because I'm thinking my mind is going crazy, guys, because hopefully everybody knows that I love Super Street. This is the 1090 Index. Cars weigh 2,800 pounds minimum, and I'm a huge advocate for the category. And I really believe that the Super Gas style street roadsters with a bunch of weight in them is not in the spirit of the rules of Super Street. But Keith is messing me up a little bit, because this is a real car, Keith. Like, you've got, I noticed there's a horn up there. You got all the lights, you got everything. He's messing with me a little bit, and it's got a stereo. Like, I think this counts, Keith. I'm all right. If someone's going to make a street roadster out of a real convertible car and run it in the Super Street, I think I'm okay with it. All right, tell us about the cockpit of the race car. What have you done here?
All right, like, just to start with, to get in and out easier, I used a nice extension here. I've got plenty of room in this car. I'm a little scrunched up in the Porsche, but my leg room is great in here. I laid out stuff just like the Porsche with my angle for my trans brake.
Come see the trans brake button. He's got a trigger. Not too late. So that's what happens when you're getting attention in the pits.
These aren't made anymore. They're my secret weapon.
You love that.
Yeah, this is my trans brake. It's like shooting a pistol. So that's how I do my trans.
First time we've seen one of those on attention in the pits, guys. Well, give us your likes.
The Porsche, we just didn't point it out.
Oh, he tried to sneak it past us, and now it's public. Sorry, Keith.
Yes, sir. So. Yep, I added, you know, a light here so I can get my visibility. I've got spot for my pager, my glasses, my phone, even a water bottle holder in here. I've got what you'll see on the other side, the air compressor and all the electronics are very easy to get to. The layout's really good. The shifter's at an angle. Everything's ergonomic.
Ergonomic, exactly. And the stereo, the patent of Keith Mayers. You hit us with something. Look at that great switch panel.
It takes a second to turn on here, but yeah.
And then we're going to hear it run, of course, everybody, and if you're...
loud enough where I can hear it and not hear the motor. That's, you know how that goes.
And with the convertible, we're going to hear you in the tower at New England Dragway. Oh, my goodness. All right, can we hear this thing run?
Absolutely.
Fire it up. Keith Mayers, Alfa Romeo, Spider. Keith Mayers blowing our mind with this brand new car. So much time, so much effort going into this machine. Keith, thank you so much for sharing. I know you got more to it, but like this has been amazing. And he's hopping out. Thank you very much for showing us and showcasing your hot rod.
Oh, absolutely.
Thank you.
And that is why you come out into the pits at the NHRA.